Hello students, here I am going to discuss about different methods for the preparation of alcohols. Here first we consider the preparation of alcohols from alkenes, from alkenes we can prepare alcohols by various chemical reactions. Here first one is acid catalyzed hydration. So let us take a general alkene undergoing acid catalyzed hydration. We get an alcohol. So it's an alkene. React with this water in presence of an acid, that is acid catalyzed hydration, we get an alcohol. Now consider an example, CH2 double bond CH2 plus H2O in presence of an acid, we get CH3CH2OH. Now let us consider the mechanism of this reaction. Now first step, this water molecule react with this acid H plus, we get hydronium ion. Next step, protonation of alkene and formation of carbocation. That is, this alkene react with this hydronium ion. Forming a carbocation. During the formation of carbocation, there occurs a protonation at either of this carbon. So this, in this alkene, this pi electrons are loosely bounded. So this pi electrons takes one of the H plus from hydronium ion, and this shared pair of electrons transferred to here. Then what we get? We get a carbocation and water molecule. And also there is a protonation occur at one of the carbon. Next step, this carbocation react with this water molecule. Here this water being attacked as nucleophile, so we get its water molecule is attacked to this carbocation. Next step, deprotonation. deprotonation. This deprotonation means one of the H plus ion or one of the proton is removed from here by another water molecule, and this shared pair of electrons transferred to here. And what do we get? We get an alcohol and hydronium ion. So this H plus is taken by this water molecule. So we get an alcohol and this hydronium ion. This hydronium ion is generated. Hydronium ion is regenerated. So this is the general mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration. This is the mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration. That is, first step, hydronium ion is formed. Second step, carbocation is formed, and during the formation of carbocation, there occurs an protonation of alkene. Then final step, there is removal of H plus ion or deprotonation. We get an alcohol. So this is the general mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration. Now when we start from an unsymmetrical alkene like propene, CH3 CH double bond CH2, when we start from an unsymmetrical alkene like propene, that we get an alcohol, and the addition takes place in accordance with Marconic Ops rule. So when we consider an unsymmetrical alkene like propene, the addition takes place in accordance with Marconic Ops rule. That is, across C double bond C or carbon-carbon double bond, the hydrogen joins to the carbon atom which already has more number of hydrogen atoms attached to it. That is, here is a propene. It's an unsymmetrical alkene undergoing acid catalyzed hydration. We get an alcohol. Well, here propan-2-ol or 2-propanol, and this product is getting in accordance with Marconic Ops rule. That is, across this carbon-carbon double bond, the hydrogen joins to the carbon atom which already has more number of hydrogen atoms attached to it. So here this hydrogen is added to here and OH is added to here. So when we consider an unsymmetrical alkene, the product is in accordance with Marconic Ops. Now take another example, CH3 C double bond CH2 CH3 plus water in presence of an acid, we get CH3 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 OH. Here also the resulting product is an alcohol in accordance with Marconic Ops rule. So H plus is added, sorry, the H is hydrogen is added here, CH2, we get that CH3, and OH is added here, this carbon. So when we consider unsymmetrical alkene, the product is always always an alcohol in accordance with Marconi constant. So let us consider the mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration of this molecule. So first step, formation of hydronium ion. We know that the H2O plus plus H2O plus H plus gives H3O plus. Then next step, formation of carbocation. During the formation of carbocation, there occurs protonation on protonation along this carbocation. So CH3 C double bond CH2 CH3 plus H3O plus, we get carbocation. Here these pi electrons are loosely bounded and takes one of the H plus ion from here. And this shared pair of electrons transferred here. We already discussed in the previous previous page. So here is a chance for forming two types of carbocation. That are CH3 and CH3 CH2. So here this is a tertiary carbon atom, this is a primary, this is a tertiary carbocation, this is a primary carbocation. So the actual case or the reaction is proceeds through this carbocation, this carbocation is not favored here, why? We know that this tertiary carbocation is more stable than that of this primary carbocation. That's why the reaction proceeds through this carbocation. So next step, this carbocation reacts with this water molecule, we get CH3. Then final step, deprotonation by another water molecule. So another water molecule takes one of the proton from here and forming alcohol, plus H3O plus regeneration of hydronium. So the product is actually according to Marconi's rule, and also we can say that the product forming through a stable carbocation, so when we preparation of an protonation of an alkene, here the reaction the protonation can occur either of the carbon. However, the more stable carbocation is preferably formed. So two things are noted here. One is formation of stable carbocation and the Marconi constant. Two points, that is stable carbocation and
also Marconi cough syrup. Marconi cough syrup. Marconi cough syrup. Marconi cough syrup. These two things should be remembered here in this case of acid catalyzed hydration. Acid catalyzed hydration reaction.
Now let us consider another example. CH3 CH double bond CH2. CH3 CH double bond CH2 plus water in presence of an acid, we get CH3 OH CH2 CH3 plus H2O plus. So here we get a product like this. That two points, that is stability of carbocation and Marconi cough syrup. Here this Marconi cough syrup is satisfied. Here is this Marconi cough syrup is satisfied. But this OH or the hydroxyl group is attached to here. Attached to here. And this CH is changed to CH2. So actually what happened here? Now let us check. Mechanism. First step, this water molecule reacts with this H plus, we get H3O plus. That we know. Then second step, this CH3 CH double bond CH2 plus hydronium ion. Here this pi electrons takes one of the H plus from this hydronium ion, and this shared pair of electrons transferred here. This these things are already known, that is we get CH3 CH CH3 CH plus and CH3 plus H2O, and we get a stable secondary carbocation. When this H plus is attached to here, then we get a primary carbocation, that is CH3 CH CH3 CH2 CH2 plus. That primary cation is not favored because secondary is more stable than that of primary. That's why this type of secondary carbocation is formed. These things are already discussed or already told in previous pages. Now here this carbon is attached to this hydrogen, and also this C plus or this carb C plus is near to an carbon hydrogen bond, that is CH3 CH CH3 H CH plus CH3. That is, this carbon hydrogen bond is present near to this C plus or C plus. So there is a rearrangement occur. That is, this hydride ion. This hydride ion is attached to this C plus ion. Then what we get? We get CH3 CH CH3 CH plus CH3 CH2 CH3 CH2 CH3. We get a tertiary carbocation. Here this is a secondary carbocation, and this secondary carbocation is changed to tertiary carbocation through simple rearrangement. So this tertiary carbocation is changed to tertiary carbocation. This tertiary carbocation is more stable than that of this secondary carbocation. Then Next step, this tertiary carbocation CH3 CH3 CH2 CH3 plus water molecule, we get CH3 CH2 CH3. Next step, deprotonation by another water molecule, that is this H plus is taken by water molecule and this side pair of electron is transferred to here and we get CH3 OH CH2 CH3 plus H3O plus. This is the product. So here is a rearrangement is also occur, because here is the secondary when this secondary carbocation changed to this type tertiary carbocation by a simple rearrangement, because this C plus ion is present near to a CH bond, is near to a CH bond, though this hydride ion is moved from here to this C plus ion and we get a tertiary carbocation. That's why we get a product like this. So in the case of acid catalyzed hydration, this type of rearrangement is also possible for getting a stable carbocation. So these are all the things, or these are all the things related to mechanisms of acid catalyzed hydration. Next, hydroboration oxidation reaction. Hydroboration oxidation reaction. Here, alkenes react with diborane, followed by the reaction with hydrogen peroxide in presence of an alkali, aqueous alkali, we will get an alcohol. Here, an alkene, let us take propene, react with diborane, diborane, that is BH3 twice, that is, or B2H6, that is BH3 twice. Followed by hydrogen peroxide in presence of aqueous alkali, we will get an alcohol, CH3, CH2, CH2OH, or propene, this is propanol, or propan-1-ol, or simply propanol. Here, this product obtained is in a way accordance with anti-Marconi Kops rule. The product is in accordance with in a way accordance with anti-Marconi Kops rule. And the addition is syn addition. So here in hydroboration reaction, the addition takes place in accordance with anti-Marconi Kops rule, and is this in syn addition. That is, this hydrogen and OH are added on the same side of carbon-carbon double bond. Here this CH3, H, OH, H, or the addition is syn addition. Addition is syn addition. Or this hydrogen and OH are added on the same side of this carbon-carbon double bond. So this is hydroboration oxidation reactions. Very important reaction. That is, alkenes react with diborane. Diborane means B2H6. We can write it just in BH3 twice. Actually, it is B2H6. Followed by the reaction with hydrogen peroxide in the presence of aqueous alkali, we get an alcohol. We get an alcohol. Here, this propene is converted to propanol. This addition is in accordance with anti-Markovnikov's rule, and the addition is in syn addition. Addition is syn addition. That is, the hydrogen and oxygens are added to the same side of carbon-carbon double bond. Now, let us check the mechanism of this reaction. Mechanism of this reaction. Here, generally main two steps are occur. First step is hydroboration. Second step is oxidation. Here, first step, hydroboration step. Hydroboration step. In this step, this addition of borane to alkane. Borane means BH3 to alkane. Borane to alkane. This addition, that is CH3, CH double bond, CH2. Borane means H, B, H. This BH3, that is borane. This addition is proceeds through a concerted reaction, that is bond breaking and bond forming through occurs at same time, and this addition is in takes place on the same side of the double bond. That is, this addition is a concerted reaction, and also this addition takes place on the same side of double bond. This concerted means bond breaking and bond forming occurs at same time. So here this bond here and this here. What we get? CH3, CH, CH2. So it's a transition state between the product and these molecules. It will convert it to CH3, CHH, CH2, BH2. So the first step is hydroboration. In this step, this borane is added to this alkene. This addition proceeds through a concerted reaction, that is bond breaking and bond forming occurs at same time, and also this addition takes place on the same side of carbon-carbon double bond, on the same side of carbon-carbon double bond. So this is the first step, or this is the initial step of this hydroboration oxidation reaction. Then after this, the resulting alkyl borane that is CH3 CH2 CH2 BH2. The resulting alkyl borane still has two hydrogens, and the reaction repeats two more times, converting it into trialkyl borane. That is, this alkyl borane again react with another alkene, CH3, CH2, CH2, H plus CH3, CH2, sorry, CH3, CH double bond, CH2, CH3, CH double bond, CH2. What we get? This, this hydrogen is added to here, and this Br is added to here. That is what we get. CH3, CH2, CH2, BH, CH2, CH2, CH3. Next step, here this dialkyl borane contains one more hydrogen. This again it react with another molecule of alkene, that is CH double bond CH2. What we get? CH3, CH2, CH2, B, then here CH2, CH2, CH3, and here CH2, CH2, CH3. Or we get a trialkyl borane. Here this alkyl group, we take propyl, so this is tripropyl borane. Generally we can say it as a trialkyl borane. Here we say it as tripropyl borane. Then after the formation of this trialkyl borane, here this tripropyl borane, the second step, that is oxidation. Here in this step, the hydrogen peroxide reacted with that aqueous alkali, get a peroxide ion plus water molecule. This peroxide ion behaves as a nucleophile. Next step, this peroxide ion attacks this borane, that is here CH3, CH2, CH2 three times. Three times. Plus this nucleophile attacked here. Then what we get? We get CH3, CH2, CH2B, CH2B. Then here CH2, CH2, CH3, and you can get like this. After this, there is a rearrangement of this molecule, that is this alkyl group is attached to, and this alkyl group alkyl group is then attached to this oxygen, and here is elimination of hydroxide ion or OH minus. Then what we get? We get CH3, CH2, CH2, B, CH2, CH2, CH3, 4, CH2, CH2, CH3. Then this molecule again, OH peroxide ion or this nucleophile ion attack here, then what we get? CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, O, CH2, CH2, CH3, O, O, H. Here in next step, this alkyl group is attached to here and OH minus is removed. Then what we get? We get CH3, CH2, CH2, B, O, CH2, CH2, CH3, O, CH2, CH2, CH3. Then again, one more peroxide ion is attached here. What we get? This same process repeat once more. We get CH2, CH2, CH3, O, CH2, CH2, CH3, F, O, CH3, CH2, CH2O. Then, after the formation of this molecule, that is CH3, CH2, CH2O, B, O, CH2, CH2, CH3, O, CH2, CH2, CH3. This molecule is undergoing reaction with the aqueous alkali. We will get three molecule of CH3, CH2, OH, two molecule of alcohol and boric acid, that is H3BO3. This boric acid again react with this aqueous alkali NaOH to be converted to a sodium borate, that is side product. This is the required alcohol. This is the mechanism of hydroboration oxidation reaction. First step, hydroboration step. Second step is oxidation. So these are the mechanism of hydroboration oxidation step. Hydroboration oxidation reaction. So we can write that is CH3 molecules. The balance the equation balanced equation is 3CH3 CH double bond CH2 BH3 twice, that is B2H6 HOOH hydrogen peroxide in presence of aqueous alkali, but we get 3 molecules of propanol. Three molecules of propanol. Now, let us take another example. That is one methyl cyclopentene. One methyl cyclopentene. The three molecules. B2H6. That is BH6. That is diborane. H2O2 hydrogen peroxide. Presence of OH minus. What we get? Three molecules of an alcohol. H. Then can another example, three molecules of CH3 double bond CH2 H2O2 B2H6 similarly in aqueous circle. What we get? We get three molecules of CH2 OH. So this is very important reaction, hydroboration oxidation reaction. This reaction is an excellent method. It's an excellent method for the preparation of alcohol. And this method also have very good product yield. Very good product yield. So very important reaction. Very important reaction. It's an excellent method. It also has very good very good product yield. So it's a very important reaction, that is hydroboration oxidation reaction. Hello, next we have to discuss about oxymercuration and demercuration. Oxymercuration and demercuration. Oxymercuration, demercuration. This reaction is also used for the preparation of alcohols from alkenes. Here we consider an alkene RCH double bond CH2. React with mercuric acetate in a mixture of tetrahydrofuran and water, followed by reduction with sodium borohydride, yields an alcohol plus Hg plus ACOH. Here this HgOAC means mercuric acetate. HgOAC, that means mercuric acetate, that is HgCH3COO ties, that is mercuric acetate. This HgCH3COO ties is short HgOAC ties, that is mercuric acetate. So this is oxymercuration demercuration reaction. In this reaction, the alkene react with mercuric acetate in a mixture of tetrahydrofuran and water, followed by reduction with sodium borohydride. Active and not subjected to any type of rearrangement. This mechanism or the addition between this carbon-carbon double bond follows Markovnikov's rule. Follows Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov's rule. That is, the H is added. To the carbon with a higher number of hydrogen atoms, or the during this formation of alcohol, this hydrogen will be attached to the carbon with higher number of hydrogen atoms. So here CH3H, okay, and this OH will be attached to here, this CH. So the product or the mechanism follows Markovnik's rule of regioselectivity. Now let us consider the mechanism of this oxymercuration demercuration reaction. Okay. This oxymercuration demercuration reaction is a two-step reaction. First step means, or first we'll conduct oxymercuration, then followed by it demercuration. That is, first step is oxymercuration. So consider this as an example. RCH double bond CH2. Here first this alkene is react with this mercuric acetate. Here this pi electrons shifted to here, and this SiO minus or acetate ion is liberated. Then what happened? We get RCH plus CH2 HgOAc plus ACO minus ion. Then next step, this number of electrons takes here. Then what happened? RCH2HgOAc. So there is a cyclic intermediate for mercurinium ion. Cyclic mercurinium ion is formed. Next step, this addition of water, that is RCH2C plus OAC. Then addition of water plus H2. Here this water molecules attacked here, and this molecule shifted to here. Then what we get? RCHOHH CH2 HG OAC. So when we added this water molecule, it will attack this CH here, and this shared pair of electrons transferred to here. After this formation of this intermediate, that intermediate is like this RCH CH2 HGOAC. After this, the hydrogen or the one of the proton is removed from here, that is the shared pair of electrons transferred to here, and this proton H plus is taken by the acetate ion, ACO minus ion, taken this. This acetate ion is removed from the first step. Yeah, acetate ion taken this H plus. What we get? We get R CHOH CH2 HGOAC. Then this is the first step. That means oxymercuration. In second step, demercuration. In demercuration, this product, that is RCHOH CH2 HGOAC, undergo reduction by sodium borohydride NaBH4 in basic medium. So in basic medium, then the reduction of oxymercuration product with sodium borohydride in basic medium yields the alcohol plus Hg plus acetic acid. So this is the mechanism of oxymercuration demercuration reaction. Now let us check another example. CH3 CH double bond CH2. This on oxymercuration demercuration reaction, this mercuric acetate Hg OAC twice in THF and water medium, followed by alkaline sodium borohydride. What we get? We get CH3 CH CH3 CHOH CH3. This is the product. Now the mechanism of this reaction. First step, thus alkene react with this mercuric acetate. Alkene react with mercuric acetate, that is CH3 CH CH3 CH double bond CH2 plus HG OAC here is electron attack, here is transferred to here. What we get CH3 CH plus CH2 HG OAC HG OAC. Next step, this carbocation, this transferred to here. What we get CH3 CH CH3 CH CH2 HG OAC. So here this mercurinium bridge or this bridge stabilizes the carbocation intermediate. So there is no rearrangement, so that carbocation cannot rearrange with this hydrogen. After this formation of this, it will react with another water molecule. This attached to here, and this is shifted to here. What we get? CH3 CH CH3 CH OH H plus CH2 HG OAC. Next step, this acetate ion, the acetate ion from first step is taken by one of the this acetate ion takes this hydrogen, and this lone pair of this shared pair of electrons transferred here. What we get CH3 CH CH3 CH OH CH2 HG OAC. Then last step, demercuration with alkaline or base sodium boron hydride in basic medium, or alkaline sodium borohydride, alkaline. What we get? CH3 CH CH3 CH OH CH3 plus HG plus acetic acid. So this is the mechanism for oxymercuration demercuration reaction of this alkene. It's a very important reaction for your exam. It's a simple mechanism. First step is oxymercuration, then second step is demercuration. Oxymercuration takes place by the mercuric acetate in tetrahydrofuran and water as medium. Then after this oxymercuration, demercuration or reduction of this oxymercuration product by sodium borohydride in basic medium, we will get an alcohol in accordance with Marconi rule of regioselectivity. So this is oxymercuration demercuration reaction.